Michael Hayes came to me and was like, yeah, you're going to get a band. I'm like, great. Who is it? Jinder and Drew.
The most logical choices of all.
Is that how you found out?
Serious.
That's exactly how I found out. I literally said, huh? I mean, to me, it sounded like a bad joke. You know, Scotsman, Indian, and a redneck walks into a bar.
Do you remember being in the locker room that morning? You hadn't known who was in the band yet, and you're like, I'm getting a band. And you even said, like, oh, maybe Dean Ambrose, maybe Kurt Hawkins, maybe Fandango.
Yeah.
And I jokingly, I was like, watch, I'll be in the band. Completely joking.
You put it in the universe,
oh,
man.
Oh, my God.
But to be honest, I wasn't doing anything at the time. I was just floating around, spinning my wheels. You know, Mr. McMahon had sat there, and he took the roster list, went through it, and went, I like that idea. Jinder and Drew McIntyre.
I am pretty sure that's probably what happened.
Oh, yeah. And I know, like, we were very, you know, serious. He'd only ever seen us do the one dimension. And I know his thinking at the time would be, all right, let's see, you know, if they can keep up with Heath in the entertainment aspect, which is very difficult to do.
Pump it up. I'm the chosen one.
You guys remember where we almost killed 3MB because we didn't know that we were supposed to air guitar or be a rock band. I'm Indian dancing. You're air guitaring. I can't remember what you're doing.
I think it was just thrusting away.
You were thrusting. You loved the thrust. You know?
I don't know. Maybe I didn't think maybe it was a rock band. I don't know what I was thinking. Remember we actually went to get gear made? And I was going to get the trunks just like rock and roll style. I think you were too.
Yeah.
And then they're like, everybody in leather pants.
Yeah. Yes.
Oh, okay.
I was like, man, we're going to be hot as hell and these things going out there working.